Welcome everyone. In this presentation, we will deal with the physical property color of the minerals. Color is something most of us are familiar with. We may say that color of a mineral is the appearance it gets from the way in which it absorbs light. This property is often confused with luster. Opposite of color, luster is the appearance of the mineral it gets from the way it reflects light. The difference is subtle, but it is crucial to understand it. Luster is related to the shine and texture of the mineral, but color is different. White light is supposed to be a spectrum of colors. When this light falls on, suppose any blue material, the mineral absorbs yellow, red, green, and any other color of the spectrum which is not blue. Hence, only blue light remains, which is then reflected, and that is what we see. Generally speaking, minerals containing aluminium, sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and barium have a light color or they are colorless. Minerals containing iron, chromium, manganese, nickel, titanium, and copper are darker minerals. Color of mineral is often its most striking property, but unfortunately, colors of minerals vary very greatly. How greatly? So much so that the color of a mineral may be purple, yellow, gray, or it may be colorless, but the mineral may only be quartz. Quartz is composed of silicon dioxide and is commonly colorless, but it is sometimes also found in a wide array of different colors. The reason for the variation in color of mineral is as varied as the color of the mineral itself. But broadly, the color observed may be the mineral's true color or it may be colored by some other element. On this basis, minerals can be ideochromatic, where the coloring element is also a major constituent of the mineral. Example of an ideochromatic mineral is olivine, where the green color comes from the divalent ferrous iron. But just a single change in the valency of iron, that is, trivalent ferric iron, would give a mineral red, brown, yellow, or blue color, and in the case of almandine, gives a red color. And valency is not the only factor which affects color. Different types of bonding can also cause varied color of the same element, which is in the case of diamond and graphite. The true color of fluorite is green, but it is also found in purple color due to Frenkel defect. Where Frenkel defect is a dislocation defect in a crystal, where usually a smaller ion of the constituent particle gets displaced from its position into the space between the larger ions. So far, we discussed ideochromatic minerals. Now let us explore allochromatic minerals in which the coloring agent is not a major constituent but rather an impurity. Orthoclase feldspar is an allochromatic mineral since the red color is caused by iron, but iron is not a constituent element of orthoclase but is rather an impurity. The milky appearance of milky quartz is due to the presence of air bubbles in its silicate structure. Since this color does not come from constituent particles, that is SiO2, it is an allochromatic mineral. Amethyst is another allochromatic quartz which we saw earlier, and it gets its violet color also by iron. Rose quartz gets its color from diamantite crystals, although earlier it was believed that the source of pink color is titanium, iron, or manganese, which is now known that it isn't. Beryl can be of many colors due to the small amounts of different trace elements, and its vivid green variety is called emerald, whose color stems from chromium impurity. There are various properties of minerals based on color, like play of color, change of color, scheller, opalescence, iridescence, tarnish, and pleochroism. We would only discuss play of colors here, but I would encourage you to explore all these other properties yourself. Play of colors is a mineral property by which a mineral displays a changing series of prismatic colors when turned about or looked at in different directions. And diamond is one such example that shows this property. In this image, we can see play of colors being shown by labradorite. At last, we finish our discussion on color with a brief listing of minerals of various colors. Minerals olivine, epidote, chlorite, glaubonite, and serpentine are of green color, whereas quartz, calcite, and gypsum can be colorless. Quartz, feldspar, and calcite can be white, and graphite, tourmaline, and biotite are black minerals. Like habit, sometimes knowing the color of various minerals help us to easily identify them. In this granite rock, we can easily identify constituent minerals because we know that the gray parts are quartz, pink colored mineral is feldspar, and black grains are hornblende. Similarly, we identify various mica minerals on the basis of color only, as white mica is muscovite, black mica is biotite, and purple mica is lepidolite. With this, I end this presentation. Thank you.